What has been going on in the beautiful world of the MMX this week?
Yeah, it was really time to try to do something about the sound of the marble funnels. When we designed these marble funnels, it was just like trying to make them look as cool as possible, you know? And on the marble machine, a special design requirement is to leave a lot of air and space. I wanted a kind of transparent funnel, but all transparent materials are like plastic, and I knew I didn't want a plastic funnel. So we ended up with this steel cage, the stainless steel cage, and I was like over the moon happy about the looks and the function and everything. But the big problem was the sound, and the team members kept asking me, is it not going to be a problem with the sound? And I was like, no, signal to noise, we just choose the right microphone. No. That is kind of a very naive way of doing things. This naivety has now caught up with me, and the sound of these stainless steel funnels is actually a real problem. So here you can hear a test I made with the hi-hat. I recorded this with a very strange microphone, so it sounds bad, but you can hear clearly that the sound of the marble funnels is actually equally strong as the sound of the hi-hat. As I explained, you can fix this by putting contact microphone on the hi-hat or putting a microphone much closer to the hi-hat away from the funnels and stuff like that. But I wanted to try to fix this problem at the source by actually reducing the sound of the funnels themselves. When I told about this problem, we were swamped by the idea to dip the funnels in plastidip. I didn't have plastidip, but Alex ordered me these products that is like plastidip. So it was time to take the funnels off the machine and start to coat them with this transparent rubber coating for automotive industries. Today I've been making a lot of coatings and I'm not really happy yet, but this is the funnels and I want to put some more coatings, and I can really already feel that the metal sound is gone.
Oh, wow.
It's more of a duller sound. So right now I'm going to head over on the marble machine and try this on the machine.
So the feel of this funnel is completely different. And the rubber looks great. It just created a gloss. So I attached it here. Well. Ah, it's so much better. It isn't perfect, but it's so much better. Wow, did you hear that? I think I can increase the layer thickness to reduce the sound further. And maybe use a real plastidip product where I'm actually dipping the funnels rather than spraying. Let's now add this that hasn't had a treatment. And go back to the treated one. Wow, did you hear that when I was holding here? Holding there.
Are you happy with it?
I am really, really happy. If, as you can see in the before and after, we made a big difference and it just looks actually better. So yeah, it's a big success actually. I'm really happy. This was a really annoying thing. You know what Tim Keller told me the other day?
What?
He said that the Marble Machine X is not sunken cost fallacy. I was so happy as we hear.
Okay, he's a good liar though.
You say goodbye to the audience,
Hannes. See you later. This was the final episode of Wintergatan Wednesdays. I think we ended on a high note. Well, Martin, surely the funnels weren't the only thing you worked on this week.
After renovating the music studio, I'm back as project manager for the Marmstein X project. I'm working on these yellow tasks of populating the task list. And the task list looks like this. And we have quite a lot of fun things going on. Lucas is working on a lifting solution, which we're gonna put some bolts in the legs of the Marmstein machine to make it easy for me to move it around when recording video. Richard is working on these cyber couples. Here's the inbound ramps. It was a Discord suggestion. They're gonna make it silent when the marbles go into the plywood gear here. When I'm looking at the issues list, I've been color coding things. So the yellow is the ongoing tasks. The green is the finished tasks. All these green ones over here is me fixing the music studio. The blue issues is everything that's going to be solved with the marble divider redesign. I have realized that I almost delegated everything that I can delegate right now. So that's quite an achievement for the PM butterfly. And now I need to design some stuff in CAD before I can delegate it for manufacturing. So today I'm gonna do exactly that with this pink task here. Issue number 60, conveyor belt intro. So let's head over to Fusion 360 and look at the old design. As you can see, there's a lot of parts, and when I tried this design on the machine, I realized this is way overcomplicated. We don't need to constrain the marbles as hard as I thought. That just causes issues. We can just basically make an open tray for the conveyor belt to pick up marbles in. So I can delete all this. But I don't want to redesign this from scratch. I'm just going to basically butcher the old design. You can see the little triangle I get there. It's because I'm in the middle of the line. So I'm just going to add a little here. Let's add 40 millimeters. See, I'm locking onto the line there. That means the spline is tangential with the side. So I'm happy with that shape. And then I can just take mirror. And I'm gonna choose this line and this line. I'm gonna de-choose this line, and then I'm gonna choose this line as a middle line. And there you see it's mirroring on the other side. So now we have a symmetric shape. I have an 18 millimeter opening of the PMMA pipe. I want this opening of the PMMA pipe to be tangential with the level of the floor. Like that, boom. And then if I make a 22 millimeter, which is the outside diameter, and I extend so it's not a construction line anymore. And if I then show the body, I can then make an extrusion, and then we have a cutout for the pipe. So minus 20 millimeters, that's the entry of the pipe. This whole thing is hurting my CAD pride now. I'm gonna start over next to it. New component. Yes, I'm gonna throw you away. Size of a marble, 15.875. Boom. This, the thickness of the acrylic, 15. So cute they are, the marbles there, waiting to be picked up by the conveyor belt. And I want this angle to be 8 degrees. Boom. And I want this little detent to be a little bit longer. Then I can go back to my plane and do it 5 degrees instead. Did you see how that little detent became longer? Because I'm like reducing the angle of the plane. So now again, I can cut the opening for the PMMA pipe. And now we're gonna make a top side of this. We don't need 6 screws, Martin. That's typical Martin 2019 idea. 4 screws is enough. And the acrylic stock is 15, so we take this 15 millimeters straight up. So I actually cut a little bit here on the underside so we could clamp with the screws on this PMMA pipe. You will see the PMMA pipe from the top. It's actually pretty cool. Here you can clearly see the cutout I made for the clamping. I think that feature is really nice in this design. Are you ready for the final comparison? This is Martin Moline a la 2019. This is Martin a la 2020. No complicated topside. And we're not like trying to constrain the marbles more than they need to be constrained. I've noticed that the marbles are behaving great if they're just free in a tray. The conveyor belt is picking them up. This part broke when the conveyor belt broke. So now I'm just gonna upload this step file into Dropbox, put the Dropbox link in a project charter, send it off to the octopus, and in a couple of weeks, this part will arrive to me manufactured, hopefully, and it will work. Yeah!
And I put it on Discord, and Alex CNC accepted the task. Alex CNC has made all the acrylic parts with flame polishing and stuff. So I was very happy.
And speaking about the E-team, I've been talking to Christof, a new face in the team. What are you currently working on the machine itself?
Mainly, I'm responsible for the sound wiring, which is the pure wiring. So I'm not picking a microphone. That's easier if you're close to the machine. That's Martin. But getting all the microphones that are already on the machine and that are coming to the machine ready and wired in a neat manner. So no cables hanging into gears that are moving and no cables being ripped off or melted while somebody is welding. Exactly how the cables are routed will come a little later and is not important right now. So we're making a sound central, how Martin calls it, in the back of the MMX that everything will be connected to. But how we keep the cables out of moving gear is a decision that we much easier can make on the machine. So we wait with that until we can all meet in France and decide that.
One of my different projects is a holder for microphones under the Vibraphone. It has to be flexible because we don't know exactly how the Vibraphone resonator pipes are going to look in the end. They might be open or closed, short or long, bent or straight. That is still very much up for debate. And one of those flexible solutions is spanning a net close to the resonator pipes and just hanging several microphones in that net. So I built a frame, and what I used is a carbon fiber pipe and rubber connectors that you can easily buy off the shelf that are normally used for kites. And because they're rubber, you can just slide things along to stretch the net a little more or less. And then you have exactly the type of net you want. The double layer net gives us the opportunity to angle a mic in a certain way by just using different holes in the top and the bottom net. So the hope is that this net is dampening enough so that all the noise that is inside the frame of the MMX will not transfer to the microphones, and they will only catch sound that's in the air, not in the frame.
Ding, 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 ding. Oh, the mail just arrived with Christoph's package.
Oh my God, how exciting, live.
Thank you. Whoa! Whoa! Check this out.
Wow! Paper.
Wow! These are so cool. Carbon fiber sticks. Oh, beautiful elastics! I've never seen so cool elastics. I think with this I can build any frame I want, and I love all the pieces you sent, Christof. So awesome! Thanks for being part of the MMX E team and deliver so cool stuff.
Christof delivers. Wow.
Christof delivers big time. Thank you, Christof. Awesome.
Speaking about people who delivers big time.
C-O-M-M-U-N-I-T-Y C-O-R-N-E-R Community Corner.
Wow.
What? It's fantastic. Why is the water purple in the end? And Benton Collins photography is maybe aware of that ice is my favorite thing, that I drink everything with ice.
It's so cool. I only have one big critique on that video. Where okay. was my name in the stars?
What? He used a list in YouTube about contributing, and you didn't help at all with the Marmchen exercise, Hannes. So oh. I'm sorry.
Okay, yeah, well, that's true.
You were just it's there, like, me. Drying up my tears when I wanted to stop with the first machine, and you has been there ever since. But apparently Benton Collins doesn't care about that.
Nah, he doesn't care about me.
Fantastic editing, and
the floating angle grinder.
Thank you, Benton. Really, really awesome. Wow. Wow. Okay. This is fantastic. And you know what? If you just put some more dampening material in the box, you have like a perfect sound where the marbles are falling. Look at me like teaching other people how to stop the marbles from sounding while I'm like failing exactly with that thing in the same video. Przemek Pytel, I am really impressed by what you did here. I think I never heard a marble machine being able to play so fast and so good. And I think you just absolutely pulled this one off.
Hi, Hannes and Martin. The little sister of the MMX. The brain, an Arduino Nano with power transistors and keyboard. The mechanical control unit for the marbles and the solenoids. The marble divider.
Cool.
The lifting wheel.
Wow.
And the Glockenspiel.
Wow. Thomas, thank you so much for showing this. This is awesome. The whole design of this machine, Thomas, is like how I wished I had designed my machine if I designed it completely in CAD from the beginning. Everything looks so clean and things just working. Wow, Thomas, that was really impressive. And I just searched for Exergia and I found his YouTube channel. And Thomas has like invented a candle car kit, thermo generator. There is so much cool stuff. Kurbel generator. So this candle car looks amazing, like a car that burns on a candle, I guess. So check out Exergia's YouTube channel. Awesome, Thomas. Thank you so much for sending it in. Por todos las chicas y chicos de España, tenemos un YouTube channel, se llama Wintergatan Esp. Estudio guitarra flamenca en el sur del España, en la ciudad de Sevilla. Hablar un poquito, comprender nada, pero mon amigo Carlos, he is a very nice guy and he is translating all our Wintergatan videos into Spanish on the Wintergatan Esp YouTube channel. If you know anyone from Latin America or Spain who you think might be interested in becoming part of the Wintergatan community, please tell them about the Wintergatan Esp YouTube channel, because the algorithm is not really finding it yet. So if you could tell them about that, would be a great help for the Wintergatan YouTube channel. And I actually did study flamenco guitar in Sevilla in the south of Spain. I was a disaster as flamenco student, but I picked up a little bit of Spanish, but Carlos is doing it really well. Thanks to Carlos Montoro from Anjuda Guitars for making all the translations for the Wintergatan Esp Spanish YouTube channel. Check it out.
Well, that was all the lovely bits and pieces for this week's episode. We just want to thank you all for watching and following along on the process. And you know, we see you next week on the next Wintergatan Wednesdays. Take care, everybody. Bye.
Boo. Boo.